All right, welcome back. All right, we're gonna wait for some people to come on in. Take your time there. You'll notice that that during the break I did a costume change. Just call me Eddie Gaga. Hey, want to see something slick? I noticed when I was putting this on. You want to watch Frank Zappa's face age before your eyes? Check it out. Isn't that amazing? Once again, folks, thank you very much for coming. I was really afraid that we were going to lose all our audience to the Grateful Dead cover band that's playing upstairs, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Okay, so we're going to just continue on, folks. And unlike last set, I will actually stop after several tunes so I can chat with you some more, okay? But enjoy some more of the music of Frank Zappa.
Thank you.
Okay, there's some kind of esoteric 60s stuff for you. Any of you remember a band from England called The Move? All right. Well, that little smattering, that was one of my favorite bands. The guy in the band that wrote this next song, his name is Jeff Lynne, who went on to form Electric Light Orchestra and then the Traveling Wilburys. Not to mention all the stuff that he produced for George Harrison. Anyway, this song is an unbelievable piece of music, and we're going to record it one of these days. And it's called Open Up, Said the World at the Door.
Thank you.
Dan Pearson.
Thank you.
Thank you. One of the things I wanted to tell you, you'll notice that we do a lot of songs, like one right after another, and I don't tell you what songs they are. That's by design. One of the little games that people come and play with our band is to try to figure out what songs that, like, in the middle of like one song, I might throw in like three other little Zappa themes, and people go, "Did he do this one? He did this." So that's why on my Facebook page, I always put after the gigs what songs they were. And just in case, you know, and if I can't list everything because there's so much, and you could always just email me, ask me any real specifics. You can do that anytime because after all, I'm not Billy Joel Anderson.
Sometimes we have to go on his Facebook page to know what it was that we played. Like, what's that little thing?
All right, now, obviously, I love these songs so much, particularly the ones from the 60s. I love them so much that I would never be able to play the full songs. It would take too long. So what I do is I mash them up and put them all in one song. And so, like, this next thing is a perfect example. I call this the Jethro Tull mashup. Don't go crazy. It only takes a minute and a half.
It covers all the Jethro Tull catalog.
Okay, and then we're going to do something else right after that, and I'll explain that a little later. This is the Jethro Tull mashup. This consists of Bourree, which will feature Dan Pearson on the flute. It will go into a song from the Jethro Tull's first album. The song is actually a song written by Roland Kirk called Serenade to a Cuckoo, which will be played by Katie Jacoby and Becca Patterson on bass trombone. And then, of course, on top, while that's going on, then the brass comes in with Aqualung. Okay. But yeah, no. It's an instrumental, and like I said, it's gonna be done before you know it. But I'm just doing this to show you what a psycho I am, okay? There you go. All based on the Chunder's Revenge bass line. Subject. I don't know if you know it or not, but the Jimi Hendrix estate is a very litigious estate, and to record any of their music, they really put up a fight, and they do anything they can to get anyone to record that music, okay? The Zappa estate isn't much better, so what I figured what I'm going to do is do a mashup of four Jimi Hendrix songs and two Frank Zappa songs. The ultimate goal being to be sued six times. No, actually, the beauty of playing live and having YouTube and everything is that eventually this will be on YouTube, and because I can never record this on an actual album because of the litigious nature of the estates. So you get to enjoy this in a live situation, all right? What you're hearing right now, the drums and bass are doing Jimi Hendrix's Little Miss Lover. You feeling that? What's next? And by the way, guys, after when we start, it's no more vamp. Just read and enjoy. Next will be the trombones playing Voodoo Child. That's right, Voodoo Child by Trombones, exactly the way Jimi Hendrix intended it. One, two, three, four. Foxy Lady on guitar. Band of Gypsies on the saxophone. On the Barry sax. We'll be right back. Anyone recognize what Ted Cushion on the keyboard is? Anyone recognize that TV theme? Twin Peaks! This project also shows I watch way too much fucking TV. Oh, actually, I was giving strict instructions by Katie because our family's here, not to curse.
Just rewind.
No, like I did at the Philadelphia World Cafe. But anyway, I apologize, Jacoby family. But anyway, we're nearing the end of our set here. And I know exactly. Well, don't hang on. I figure what better way than to do the darkest music ever written. Now, here's a question. Do we end this particular mashup that we just did? No. That or do the first chord of the next song? Okay, now this is a C minor chord with a flat six.
Not for very much longer.
Now, what's that? What I want to hear Bob Coranta play the E minor chord, and we're all going to decide which one's more ominous.
Okay,
ready? 2, 3, 4. Yeah, get back to the other one. You like, okay. And one more time, Bob. Which one do you like better? Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to finish up the mashup as I wrote it, and right into it, Bob, you guys are going to play the E minor. Ready? Together we can work something out.
They're gonna clear out the studio. They're gonna tear down all the... They're gonna whip down all the... They're gonna sweep up all the... They're gonna pay.
gonna get out of it as they prepare. Finally in Delaware after 6 long years. I'll be able to pay that parking ticket finally. It's up to $1,100 now. I'm looking forward to that. I hope you've had a good time, everybody. But I know that the best is yet to come, because we're gonna roll out of here, out onto Market Street, find a little bar. We're gonna go in there and look like semi-rock stars. Some lovely lady at the bar is going to ask me if I know Katie. I will say yes. Whatever works. And I know tonight in that lonely bar on Lonely Market Street, before our lonely drive up 95, and I know for a fact, I know positively, I am dead certain that tonight I am going to get Hokesson, Delaware.
You want us to come back? Want to hear a little more? I'm not gonna make you beg for it. We're gonna play a little more before we go. Well, never mind. We're gonna finish off the same way we started. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the Ed Palermo Big Man. On tenor saxophone, Bill Straub. Phil Chester. Clifford Lyons. Danny Pearson. Barbara Cefelli. Becca Patterson. Mike Boshin. Ronnie Wilkins. On lead trumpet, Ronnie Buttigieg. trumpet, but a fine person in his own right, John Bailey. On piano, Bob Corata. On keyboards, Ted Cushion. On bass, Paul Adamy. On drums, Ray Marchica. And on guitar, vocals, and production of my albums, Bruce McDaniel. And Katie Jacoby's mother, Esther Jacoby. And let's not forget, Katie Jacoby. Thank you, everybody. Go out and buy stuff.